And as I was saying, welcome to More Than Modern, yes. Round 2, Wei Ming versus Michael Ng.
We were talking all the way with the mic muted.
Yeah.
Skills. Pure skills, guys.
Something about only human.
Only human.
Only human.
Oh, okay. Anyway, we were saying that Michael didn't have a good start because he needed to play the land to play the Simigrove Chamber, but now
he has Vesuva too.
Yes, he has Amulet.
Oh, okay.
So now he's floating too. He plays Explore, I think. Draw a card, extra land.
Okay.
He can do that again.
That's not quite a Summer Bloom, but
okay. Cavern of Souls, please. I'm gonna go and figure out what.
Yeah. Okay.
Is.
Thanks, Solomon. So now we mix the. I think Mono Black stuff. Maybe he has Phyrexian Obliterator. That would be fun. He plays Ghost Quarters, it seems. Okay. And there's Gatekeeper of Malakir. Kicker. If you pay the kicker, he sacrifices a creature. Okay. That's interesting. I like to see some innovation. This is some innovation. Okay. So there, Michael untaps and draws. Oh wait, okay. Cass, what do you feel of Gatekeeper of Malakir?
Good stuff. In a mono black deck. Okay, the card that we didn't know what it was Sakura Tribe.
Sakura Tribe Elder?
No, the Sakura Tribe Scout or something like that.
Oh, okay.
It's basically a 1-mana, 1/1 tap, you can put a land into play.
Oh, that's cool.
There we go, Joshua. Here, Sakura Tribe Scout, yeah.
Joshua be too late on that. Well, Michael has a gemstone mine in his hand. Okay. So we can tell that Michael's playing some sort of amulet bloom deck without the bloom part. Because bloom is banned.
Yeah.
The amulet part is online, but we're gonna see where's the part that sticks it all together. I don't know. Okay, I guess Ghost Quarter. So I think they're trying to clarify on some rulings here. If Ghost Quarter takes my stuff, then what can I do? Okay. So now, okay, he plays Summoner Spec.
Another Summoners.
Okay. It's pretty good.
Azusa,
okay.
Let's see what the new...
I guess that's the new Summoners, new Summer Bloom.
Okay, I want to play some lands.
Yep. Let's see the lands. Okay, so place Vesuva, copies that. Because that I untap that. Tap that for more. Okay. For mana.
Floating 2 mana.
Floating 2, okay.
Floating 4.
Floating 4. Okay, so he has 4 mana now. Now, Wei Ming might want to Ghost Quarter. Okay, Ghost Quarter that. So, you'll enter tap though. Oh no, then on the stack he'll bounce that. Okay. Okay, so what we saw there was Ghost Quarter targeted, I think, a Simic Growth Chamber, right?
He targeted the Vesuva. So Michael used the bounce trigger to bounce the Simic Growth Chamber. Then he laid the Simic Growth Chamber to bounce the other land.
Then
he found the forest from the Ghost Quarter.
Okay.
Then.
Oh, right, yeah, he did. Okay. He I think
he laid 3 lands.
Yeah, I think he laid 3. Yeah. Okay. That's okay. I think that's the amount you're supposed to lay, right? Azusa lets you lay 2 more. 3 more. Okay, let me check. Okay, let's check.
Azusa doesn't lay 2 more land, right? Huh?
Azusa lost Seeking. Lays. Oh, it's. Azusa lays 2 additional lands, okay.
Okay, so. Yeah, we'll clarify this later, but I think maybe Wei Ming is a new player, so
yeah.
I think he asked Michael to backtrack a bit from the first.
Yeah, that's probably what he did. Yeah,
so that's probably what happened. So he didn't float the first 2.
Okay. So here's another Azusa. Oh, okay. What was the last Azusa? Did it die? Oh, it got removed. Okay.
Yeah, black decks.
Black decks. It looks like Victim of the Night. Okay, so tap that. Play a land. Oh, he's attacking with that. Okay. He doesn't want to play a land. Because he doesn't have a land. Okay.
Yeah, Michael has Titan in hand, so all he needs is 1 more mana, I think.
Yeah. All he needs that Vesuva, man. is that Engineer Explosives?
Now will be a good time for some Thought Seizers.
Yeah, that's right. But I don't think Wei Ming has Thought Seize though.
That's a...
If he plays, that's true. If he plays Duress, what are the chances he plays Thought Seize?
Then he can...
Maybe he has not Duress.
Well, if he doesn't have Thought Seize, maybe he has some brain maggots.
Oh, dang. That would be some good stuff. But Wei Ming thinking hard here, what to play. Okay, I was thinking maybe he might have Phyrexian Obliterator. Or maybe he has another Butcher of Malakia, that works too. Okay, bang.
Exactly what you wanted to see if you are Michael. Mm-hmm. Unless Wei Ming has another one in hand, then that would be quite good.
Yeah, that'd be pretty good. What's that? Oh, that's a Bojuka Bog.
Yep, get rid of your stuff.
That's pretty good,
Draw a card. Is it a land?
Oh,
It's explore.
That's not land, but you can look at for land.
Michael's still not dead next turn, so... But the Vampire Nighthawk is a problem.
Yeah, that's definitely a problem. You can't check the flying with a Titan.
Okay, two cast Engineer Explosives for two. You can clear the Gatekeepers.
Okay. is that Crumbling Vestige? Oh yeah, it is. Holy crap. Yes.
So gain one mana.
Gain one? Okay, untaps. Tap for next.
Two, explode it. You're dead.
Bang.
Nighthawk still a threat.
Yeah.
Yep.
Still, I would have went for the Nighthawk instead there, and then use the Titan to block the other two.
I mean, it's a 5-turn clock.
Yeah, that's true.
Better to get rid of the Malakias, I think. Okay, so then two swing. Down to eight.
Oh, that's two, not three. Okay. I thought it was three.
Turn. Okay, when a black deck passes the turn,
you might want to be
it's
careful.
It's either all lands or all removal, so...
Okay, so here's a Titan. On the stack, does he want to do anything? Nope. Okay, so we're going to get that.
Okay, look for two lands, untap, bounce.
Bounce the Tyrant Academy.
Okay, floating tree.
Transmute for...
Probably just a Summoner's Pact.
Yeah, Summoner's Pact.
Yep.
Seems good.
Keep looking for them.
Titans.
Primal Titans.
They're going to Titan you to death.
Maybe Wei Ming has some corrupts, man.
Yeah, maybe he has some. He is playing a mono black deck, so he does have some. Gaff's verdict.
Yeah, that's right. That's some good stuff, right?
Yeah,
there.
Yeah, that's right. Good stuff.
Lose
good stuff.
Life.
Yeah.
If he has another one, the clock is doubled.
Yep, pretty good by Wei Ming. Playing that mono black deck, surprisingly quite good against Bloomless Bloom.
Big man is live.
Yeah, this is live. We just now we were doing a replay for standard. It's just now there was a standard replay.
Is that arena?
Oh, that's what? Are you serious? Is that Fraction Arena?
Can't be, right?
I'll go check it out. No. He drains two. It looks like Fraction Arena. I'm gonna check it out. Hold on.
Okay. If you're Michael, I think you stick to the plan.
Yeah.
Look for them Titans. Go for some prime time, look for some lands.
But Wei Ming is I think the Titans can't outrace the Vampire Nighthawk at this point. I don't think I would say that normally, but at this point.
That's the problem with not running the
Sun
Home so you can outrace.
That's the problem of not running the the volcano thing.
That's some interesting.
Interesting.
Interesting cards in his deck.
Oh, it's Phyrexian Arena though, what the hell?
Okay, land.
Okay.
Any utility land though. That's what. That's,
yeah,
that's
like strong, like Stronghold and the haste giving thing. I think that could seal the game. Nope.
Yeah, it just looks like two bounce lands.
Yeah.
Floating four. So now the question is, does Michael have any removal in his deck for 2-3 flyer?
Yeah, I don't think he does. He doesn't have the, what's that card called? The Valakut, right, Valakut. Doesn't have Valakut, it seems.
Can't play Valakut in his deck.
Yeah, that's true. What's that?
I think that's the ogre guy.
The ogre guy?
Yes, I forgot his name.
Okay, let's look it up. Okay. Yeah, okay, well, Solomon goes and gets the... Solomon goes out and gets... How the card is? Seems that... I guess he gets a plant with the tap land. Okay. okay. what's the card? Oh, it's Rudik Tar. Okay. Okay. So, Rudik Tar.
R-U-N.
Oh, R-U-N. Rudik Tar.
Yeah.
D-H-A-I.
Yeah.
D-H-A-I.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Rudik Tar.
What the fuck?
Maybe it's. So what does he do?
I didn't read it. Okay, Google.
Okay.
Get
there. We'll get Runic Tar. Oh, okay.
Rurik Tar.
Oh, it's Rurik Tar.
Sorry, guys. Some noobism here.
Yeah, this is real.
Okay, we got it. Rurik Tar the Unbound. It's a legendary ogre warrior. So I was right.
Okay.
It's an ogre thing.
Okay.
It's vigilance, reach, and it attacks each turn if able. Whenever a creature casts a non-creature spell, it deals 6 damage to that player. It's a 6/6.
Okay, that's pretty good for Michael because it blocks the Nighthawk guy. So what Waming needs here is a removal. But drawing 2 cards a turn with Fraction Arena, maybe the removal won't be so out of reach for him. Yeah, whose turn is it right now? Okay, I think it's Waymix's turn.
Yeah, it's probably Waymix's turn. Now it's probably a bit...
Oh, another Butcher Malkier. Okay, so
okay,
this is...
He'll
not really
going to
do
plants.
Much, yeah. I think right now he just passes the turn. He can't do much.
I think the Nighthawk goes in.
Really? Rurita has reach.
Yeah.
What's the plan there?
Just kill it. I mean, if he attacks, are you going to...
Yeah, but Nighthawk gonna die.
Well, for him, for now, for Waming to win, he has to have some sort of corrupt activity. Is that Pack Rat?
I think it is.
Looks like Pack Rat.
Looks like Pack Rat.
That looks like some good stuff.
That's good stuff, alright.
Okay, then that changes things.
Yeah,
now
yeah.
You can block something.
Yeah.
With Death Touch.
Okay, so Michael draws. That looks like. I don't know what that is.
If that was the case, maybe I wouldn't have cast the Gatekeeper.
Yeah, why not?
Then you make another rat.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Then the next turn you make 2 rats.
Mm.
Then you swing on the next turn.
Whoa, Pack Rat, Blast from the Past, says Frozen Frog. Yes. I think this entire deck is a Blast from the Past. This is like a mono black deck.
I was telling Cass, he probably needs some Pack Rats in his black-green deck. I mean, if you're discarding the Liana, you can discard the some Pack Rats, man.
I don't see the flaw in that logic. The logic flows very smoothly. So here we see the Titan go swinging in. Just to get those land, just get the land trigger. Okay. Looks like...
Oh, he does have the Sun Home.
Oh, okay. Stronghold and another bounce stand, I think. Okay, so...
Looks a bit harder to win now.
Yep, a lot harder. Pack Rat can grind you out, can grind advantage out for like very long games, but I don't think this game's gonna be very long if Michael just pushes the button. So Michael having one of his lands being ghost quartered, not sure what land it is. So I think in response, Michael wants to tap the land, activate that stronghold. Oh, okay, it's the stronghold. Okay, is that stronghold or the bandit lord thing?
I think it's stronghold. Okay. He should probably go and tell Wei Ming next time that he can respond to the amulet trigger.
Yeah.
But it's okay. He's still in a very, very bad spot. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he is a new player, so I don't think he even knows that.
Yeah.
Okay, so Wei Ming, I think considering a block. Yeah. Oh, double block.
Oh, good dude. Your guy has death touch, man.
Yeah.
He has death touch, right?
Nighthawk?
Yeah, flying.
Yeah.
Flying death touch lightning, right?
Yeah. Okay, yeah, so yeah, he realizes that. He just goes blocking with that.
I remember he had a lot of stuff. Yeah. That's all I remember.
And Death Touch happens to be one of them.
No, it's
Sun Home.
Huh?
Sun Home.
What's Sun Home? How do you spell it?
Sun Home.
Oh, Sun Home. Okay. Target creature gains double strike until end of turn.
Okay, that's pretty good. So Wei Ming wants to block that.
Wants to block the ogre guy. So trades off. The Titan goes in for 6 times 2, it's like, that's 12. So taps 3, goes for another Azusa, okay. Wei Ming here might be in a bit of a pickle. Unless the 2 cards he draws are somehow really good.
Corruption, man.
Corruption.
I see it coming. I see the win. See some lethal, some better skull. It better be some corruptions.
Yeah, it better be some corruptions, man. Okay, so...
Oh, even if he got corruption, he used his ghost quarter, so he can't go for lethal. Oh,
yeah.
Land corruption, let's go.
Oh my god.
Step 1, yeah. Lay land.
Okay. Does he even have corruption in his deck?
I don't know. Probably not.
So for those of you who don't know, corrupt... deals damage equal to the number of swamps you control to target creature or player, and you gain life equal to the number of equal to damage dealt this way. It's a 6 mana sorcery.
Yeah, good stuff.
I don't think a card like that warrants the tag of good stuff, Solomon. Good stuff.
He wear one here. Gotta get the reach, man.
Oh my god.
See.
Okay, so Wei Ming here, I think what card is that? If it's really corrupt, I have to say. So Michael here, what does he lose to besides corrupt?
Nothing.
Damnation? Do you think Wei Ming runs Damnation?
Nope.
Yeah.
It's probably too expensive.
Well, if Thought Seizers are too expensive, Damnation is probably too expensive too.
Even if he has corruption, I think Michael could have bounced the better skull and just do stuff with it. I don't know, I didn't really pay attention.
What?
It's 5 mana to bounce better skull, I think. Or is it 4? So, yeah.
Okay, so plays the... So Transmutes the Tolera Academy.
Look for another summoner's pack.
Oh my god, dude, this guy is going for all out.
Or maybe just look for pack of negation.
Yeah, Pack of negation to counter whatever shenanigans Wei Ming might have in his hand.
Good stuff, no bluff.
Yep. That is good stuff.
Lay my caverns.
Okay, so.
Attack
with the.
Actually, now you can probably, I think. Attach your Battle Skull to your Primeval Titan.
Yeah. Then but I think it's just gonna go with the Primeval Titan and Battlestar attack individually. There's not much Wei Ming can do here. Michael has effectively locked him off the game with the pack of negation in his hand. So he's gonna okay. Give it to the plant, and give it to the battle skull. Okay. And bounce that. Yeah, I think Wei Ming is pretty dead here. Michael Ng just like slowly tapping his things and torturing Wei Ming.
Yep.
Waiting to kill him horribly. I wonder what Michael's waiting for. I wonder what they're both waiting for. Okay, so Wei Ming calculating, I think he's calculating the damage. Seems to be lethal if he doesn't block. Yeah, let's just think about sideboard options. What do you think Wei Ming has in his sideboard? More duresses. Maybe despise. Transgress the mind.
Actually, it should be quite hard for Wei Ming post board if Michael has any board clears like Angle of the Gods.
Oh yeah, that's true.
I think the best way for Wei Ming to win in this matchup is basically turn one Duresta to pack red, discard, and get there.
Yeah, I think that might be the only way for Wei Ming to win, is to outrace Michael with pack rats. But we're still stuck in this situation where Wei Ming is kind of figuring out what to do. So, Po, how's your day?
Tiring. Life is hard.
Yep, life is pretty hard.
Nothing. Some prata can't cure later.
Are we going for prata later?
I don't know.
Probably not. Okay, so I wonder what Wei Ming's doing here. He's thinking very hard.
Maybe he has a really good card. What's that? Dismember.
Oh, Dismember? That's a good card. But Spell of Negation. This is a better card.
That's a good card, but...
you have to block.
You have to block with your 1-1, which doesn't do much.
Yeah. You have to block the Primeval Titan, I think. Yep. Block. So, take. Okay. Yeah, Wei Ming realizes here that he lost the game long after the swing. So, okay, going to sideboards, Wei Ming versus Michael. Michael winning the first game. So, does Wei Ming even have a sideboard? Okay, he does. Okay. So, maybe... No, Fraction Obliterator is too expensive, probably. Okay, putting in... Oh, wait, what? That's Damnation!
Some Damnations, man. Some good stuff.
Why does he mainboard Damnation? Or maybe his deck is too aggressive for Damnation.
Yep.
Yeah, probably. Okay, that is some good stuff. No bluff.
That's right, man.
Frontier seems good. Not according to the crowd. But yeah, we do wish we had more Frontier crowd. The Frontier scene is growing in Singapore, so maybe in a month or two we'll have Frontier streams instead of Modern. Who knows?
We're Asians, it takes a while for us to change.
Yeah, that's true. Well, Japan changed pretty fast for Frontier.
The more Channel Fireball and Star City try and push Frontier, I think the more Singapore will follow. Eventually, it may take a while.
Yeah, that's true.
Because as people like me who are lazy to sell their cards that rotate out of standard can use them for other formats. And I think eventually if it gets more popular in the Western states, then in the end, Wizards has to like sanction it, you know.
Has to.
That's what happened to Commander.
Oh yeah, oh did it?
Yeah.
That sounds ridiculous. That sounds pretty fun. Po need you already. Blue-black Hedron Alignment.
Oh yeah.
So I heard you've been playing that blue-black Hedron Alignment deck for Frontier. How has that been working out?
I played it twice.
Did it work?
The first time I played it, I went
2-1. Yeah.
I assembled it once, which is more than average.
So apparently it is you win most of the time. You win just because blue black control.
Yes, most of the time you win because you go dig through time, get some torrential gearhawks, dig through time,
Or you play Jace. You play Jace, right?
Yeah.
Then Jace dig through time.
More dig through time.
I hope you like digging through time. So here, Wei Ming, I think he drew his 7 already. Oh, he didn't. He's still taking what sideboard out. Okay.
Don't think you bought in the damnations either.
Yeah, I don't think. You have enough spot removal for the big threats that Michael Ng has, so damnation might be the card to not go for. Okay, so yeah.
What would be the card to go for?
What?
Some corrupts, man.
Some that spicy black burn spell.
That's right.
Spicy black burn. Actually, that could be a deck. Mono black corrupt.
Might as well play some nightmares or get there.
Yeah, exactly. You know what? You know what? Maybe I'll make that deck. Mono black, corrupt. A lot of control and then win with corrupt. How about that? No, then you need some like what's that? Spells to tutor for corrupt. Is there any spell that tutor for corrupt?
Diabolic Tutor.
Wait, that's in modern, right?
I mean you can play Dark Petition.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. Oh yeah, you could, yeah, that's true. So like if essentially you play as like a mono black control deck, but with some aggro like Gatekeeper of Malakia and maybe Fraction Obliterator, then you slam, then when he's low like 10 life, slam in the corrupt and he just dies. Seems good. Okay, so I think both of them mulligan down to 6 or...
I think they're still shuffling.
Yeah, they're still shuffling, oh my god, that's pretty long. Oh, what's this? Okay, yeah, fine.
Making some deals, man.
Making some deals.
Under the table shit.
The back end under the mat.
Which we do not condone here.
Yes, we do not condone collusion of any kind in here at Grey Ogre Games. Maybe the occasional friendly split and the die roll if you can't. Well, we don't condone that either.
Yeah.
We are no super strict Asian mother kind of store. So here,
I will not say anything. Oh, turn one duress.
Yep. So maybe it goes to turn one duress. Sees two lands and a pair of negation and.
Oh, get rid of the turn one amulet. That seems like good stuff.
Yep, that's pretty good play with Wei Ming right.
Does
here.
Does he have the turn two pack rat? Is the question. That is the. Let's see.
Michael has the plunk though.
Lay the land.
All right. Lay the land. Okay. I think he's thinking of which swamp to lay, which art of swamp to play. Oh, they go for Bajuka Bog.
So he doesn't.
Oh man, that. Oh, he has Inquisition. Okay, that's still good stuff. Takes out the. Sees a Primeval Titan and the Ogre.
If I were Michael, I probably would have kept help that because you know that Michael can't cast back until like turn.
Very late, right?
Four, yeah.
Mm.
But maybe he doesn't have any 2 draw wheels, see?
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
You have 3?
You might have Liliana to play.
The Geth zombie thingy, the 3 mana coming to play due to damage. I do not know what is that.
That's
seems like lots of sausages on a rack. Must be the rack!
No, the rack doesn't. You don't have to tap 3 for the rack. I'll go check it out.
Yeah, I have to check.
Zendikar. Sacrament, yeah.
Okay, this is some out there cards, you know.
This is some really janky stuff.
So,
man.
This is a triple black Sorcery with Kicker 7. Search target player's library for up to 3 cards, exile them, then a player shuffles his or her library. If it was kicked, instead search their player's library for up to 15 cards, exile them, then the player shuffles his library.
I guess this is his replacement for Surgical Extraction.
I like this good stuff. Get rid of the amulets, you know. No combos for you.
Is that get rid of the hive mind, the amulet?
If I may get rid of 3 titans.
Yeah, you can I get rid of 3 cards, not like 3 types of cards. You can't get rid of titans, amulet, and hive mind. No, it's just 3 cards.
I think getting rid of 3 titans is slightly better, I'm not sure.
Is that Hornet Queen?
Yes.
Oh man. Spicy. Sakura Scout.
Oh, you can take out 3 lands, by the way.
Yeah, you can. you can play.
I may do some janky shit like that.
Oh my god.
Take out 3 lands, what you gonna do, bitch?
Now your land count is less. You're gonna draw less lands.
Hope you screw.
Yeah. So it does take out the two amulets and I think a land. I think that's a Vesuva. Passes the turn.
Oh, that. I see a Nighthawk in his hand. I think may have been better than Nighthawk.
Yeah, I think my
first.
Yeah, because the Nighthawk providing early pressure and Michael, not even being able to play those cards earlier anyway. I mean, they'll not really be that relevant early, so...
Okay, anyway, Michael draws one of his win cons, which is Battle Skull.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
A bit hard for Mono Black to deal, unless he brought in some artifact hate.
Or, you know, jump hate. And just kill, you have to kill the jump over and over again, though. So, place the Vampire Nighthawk, passes the turn. Okay, let's see what Michael has up his sleeve. This is like a Prime Titan. Okay.
This is why you should have saved his second.
You
should have Inquisition first, then Duress.
Ah, right, I mean, right.
Unless he drew the Inquisition, I don't know.
Yeah, he drew the Inquisition, I think. But here's. Okay, is that Game Trail? Looks like Game Trail. Oh no, it's the red green bounce land, okay.
Bang! Hit you for 2, drain you for 2. Look at that, 4-point life
swing. Every swing, holy crap, it's a good card. Vampire Nighthawk action, man.
But clearly not fast enough.
Mm.
4 mana past the turn. Michael drew a summoner's pack. So he's going to, yep, hard card, Skull.
There's a germ. Okay.
That's a bit hard to deal with.
Yeah, he probably has some removal of some sort in his hand. So
yeah, the problem is, you know, the better Skull with the plant tokens is legit.
Oh, that's true. That's true, actually. Yeah, okay, so goes with Geth's Verdict.
Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of my tokens.
I'm gonna kill a plant, man. Sure.
Wow.
Not really the best use of Geth's Verdict, but I guess when your opponent's board is really that big, might as well just use it before.
Yeah.
Gets bigger, so.
It's a bit hard.
Yeah.
Unless you got some equipments.
Oh, kick off Malakir, okay. So kick that, get rid of that, okay. Maybe he might consider keeping the
nope. No, you have to attack because if you block your Nighthawk dies, but the Battle Skull stays, you only kill the jump token, he gains life, you start losing the race, you lose your creature.
That's true. So here Michael draws
second summoner's pack.
Oh man.
Is he gonna lay and get some more plant tokens? I think that's good.
Yeah, then might want to get more plant tokens because Weiming's removal seem to be all in the form of target opponent sacrifices, yeah, sacrifices stuff. Okay, so, I forgot to draw, okay. Yeah, so padding his field out with more creatures will surely prevent Michael from being blown out by those sacrifice creature effects. Alright, so he's gonna Ghost Quarter off the red green bounce land. Okay, so float red green. Get a cuffs tap.
I think they were clarifying whether he wanted to do it
before or after the draw
step.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Yeah, we are a casual bunch here, you know.
Yeah.
Take it slow.
Well, Weiming is a new player, right? So
But yeah. The chat said that He has old cards. So
yeah,
he used to play last time. So
yeah, okay, yeah.
Let's just use a...
He's a returning player.
He's a returning player. That's
yeah,
right.
So he has two damnations. I saw the damnations in the sideboard.
There's two more damnations than me.
Yeah, that's two more damnations than most of us. So
Titan, look for some good stuff.
Yep. Gonna transmute that Toleria. And cut the deck. Okay, so Jump swings in. Okay, takes 4, gains 4. Yeah, at this point Wei Ming I think is kinda dead. Unless he really put in a damnation, but because you have point removal okay, that's a point removal, okay. That works.
The problem is not the Titan, the problem
is the battle skull.
Yeah, see now he has to play defense.
Well, they're both problems.
Against a recurring threat.
Yep. And that's Adenia Explosives. He could play it for 3 and just get rid of the only answer to Battle Skull, which wasn't even a good answer in the first place. Yep, it's Explosives. Sets it off. Sunburst for 3. Plays that, gets a plant. I think he might blow it up. Yep, just blow it up. Bang. Yeah, so now Wei Ming is on the severe back foot. Might be even crouching at this point, begging for mercy. It's the Battle Skull just batters Wei Ming out. Please, Michael, don't do this to me.
Judgment Day.
I'm sorry, man. So Wei Ming, yeah, I don't know, man. Seems like he's dead. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean It's hard for his deck to come through.
Well,
if he doesn't put any tempo or put any beaters on the board before turn 3.
Yeah, but he did have the beaters. Oh wait, he didn't have.
He went turn 1 Duress. Yeah, turn 1 Duress. Turn 2 Inquisition. Turn 3, search your deck. So there's no.
Yeah, there's no.
While you're disrupting your opponent, there's no.
Yeah, I think he focused on disruption too early in the game. He didn't put a Vampire Nighthawk, so that's the Vesuva. Okay, play that and summon a Pact, okay. Summoner's Pact for a Hornet Queen. I think Hornet Queen is gonna create 3 Death Flank, 3-1-1 Death Touch dudes, which Wei Ming will never beat into. Never be able to beat into. Yeah, a bit of an issue for Wei Ming here. Unless he needs like lots of removal. Well, he has 2 cards in hand too. So Michael hanging in there and being rewarded with this win from the start. So maybe it was his plan all along.
So those are some really
gray
hornets.
Yeah, those hornets, man. Flying hornets. Yeah, so I was saying maybe Michael's plan all along was to just endure the first few swings Wei Ming had to give and then come back from there with like his Prime Titan and other stuff. Which worked out for both games. I guess the Battle Skull kind of getting him decked life, which he lost. And the disruption that Wei Ming did to Michael didn't really do much, did it? Okay, so
the duress on the amulet was vital.
Yeah, that was pretty vital.
But the getting rid of the pack didn't do anything. So to be fair, I think the only turn 2 relevant creature that Michael was scared of was Pack Rat.
Yeah, Pack Rat.
And even then, you know, he has explosives in his deck.
Yeah, and he still has the Battle Skull to lifelink back what he loses as a defensive option. So, oh my god, who's hitting the table? So yeah, Wei Ming here. Really thinking really hard if he has any at all. Looking at the cards Wei Ming, Michael has in his hand. looks pretty hard. Okay, so yeah, that one single Vampire Nighthawk there on Wei Ming's side of the field, not really doing much as he passes the turn with four permanents in play as compared to Michael's like a billion.
Time for the Hornet beatdown.
Yep, definitely.
Throwback to Thero standard. I mean, theoretically, you can now equip the Battle Skull and the Hornet Queen and start just going to town.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Everything gets killed by
the Vampire Nighthawk.
The Death Touch. Yeah. So you just swing with everything as the plan.
Yep. Okay, so swings in. Sticks with the team. Okay.
Did the Battle Skull go?
I don't. Well, he didn't. He didn't. Okay, no, it didn't go. It's hanging back for some reason. Maybe Michael wants to torture Wei Ming more. Really wondering why the Battle Skull didn't go in though. Any ideas?
Nope.
Okay.
But at this point, it's a bit hard for Michael to lose. Playing a bit loose.
So yeah, that's alright. Oh, Victor of the Night. Okay.
I mean,
probably going on the.
You want to kill one of my hornets, bro?
Kill the Hornet Queen?
Yeah,
okay.
Sure, no problem.
But he can't block, right? Because if he blocks, the Nighthawk just dies too.
I mean, what then? Are you never blocking? Did he put any board wipes in? That's the question. I don't think we saw him put any damnations in, right?
Yeah, I don't see any. So, I think what.
I see some grey card in his hand. What's that?
Oh, it's grey card. I don't know, I can't see it. So Wei Ming here might be just going for the swing. Yeah, I think he might just want to swing here. Since what? Okay. I don't really like this play because if you're not swinging in with the Nighthawk, you're not blocking with him either. So, might as well just swing, right? Oh well. So here Michael just goes in with the jump this time. And Nighthawk blocks the gem, okay. Oh, then before damage, he...
Is he first strike?
Okay, give that one double strike.
Oh, is that... Actually, I can't really see what the card is. Is that Sunholm or maybe it's Kessick Wolf Run? I don't know.
I think it's Kessick Wolf Run.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, take stuff.
Take stuff. Okay, so it seems like he's going down to 5. Okay,
then
again.
Seven, go down to 5.
Go down to 5. Michael up to 31. Looks like Wei Ming's out at his wit's end here. Yep, just loses. That's the game. That was a very slow, grindy game.
Yep.
But Michael finally bringing it home, beats Wei Ming to the dust. I think the mono black deck was quite interesting though.
It would probably have done fine against a deck which doesn't pump out like non-stop big stuff that gets you value.
Yeah.
You know, it would probably do well against something like Jhan or maybe not even Jhan, like
Kessa's deck.
Yeah, like Kessa's deck. Like non-planewalkerish, non-burnish, non-big stuff.
Yeah, non-big stuff. Well, anyway, that's a modern round 2 Wei Ming versus Michael Ng. Victory here goes to Michael Ng, 2-0. We'll see you guys in a bit for round 3 as we're gonna sign off for a bit, put in an ad break and the replay. We'll be back after the round ends. See you guys.